Keeping up with today's fast-paced world can be difficult. Accelerate your life with iFiber Communications high-speed internet. Surf, stream, and game like never before. Give us a call at 509-754-2600 and find out more at iFiber.tv.
The Wenatchee Wild, we're back on home ice at the Town Toyota Center on Friday night to skate with the Cowichan Valley Capitals in Game 5 of the BCHL Interior Division Semifinals, with the series all even at 2 games apiece. The contest began with a lot of crunch from both sides, and the Wild came out firing, outshooting Cowichan Valley 11-3 in the first period, but unable to find the net behind Caps starting goaltender Pierce Diamond, as the score remained deadlocked at zeros after 20 minutes. In the second period, the game remained tight and chippy, as well as scoreless, until Cowichan Valley's Jordan Robert took a tripping penalty at the 9:02 mark, and Wenatchee centerman P.J. Fletcher cashed in 41 seconds later on the ensuing power play for his fifth postseason goal to break the scoring ice in the contest 29 minutes and 42 seconds into regulation and give the home side a 1-0 lead. The Wild held their straight-digit advantage through the rest of the second stanza and carried it past the halfway point of the third frame as well, until Caps defenseman Doug Scott swatted home his first goal of the playoffs, with the team skating at 4-on-4 to knot the score at 1-1 and eventually forced the proceedings to extend beyond 60 minutes. Wenatchee went into extra time having lost their only other OT game of the 2019 playoffs in Game 4 of their first-round series with the West Kelowna Warriors, but were eager to make good on Friday's opportunity and were licking their chops after Cowichan Valley's David Melaragne took a holding penalty just 3:43 deep into Period 4, and 43 seconds after taking to the man advantage which followed, right-winger Matt Dorsey dealt the finishing blow to the Capitals with his second postseason goal to give the Wild a 2-1 victory in the game and a 3-2 lead in the best-of-seven series. Starting goaltender Austin Park went the distance for Wenatchee, stopping 17 shots in 64 minutes and 26 seconds in the crease to up his playoff record to 6-2. The Wild outshot Cowichan Valley 30-18 in the contest and scored both of their goals on the power play, where they were 2-of-8, as well as being a perfect 4-of-4 on the penalty kill. Wenatchee now has a chance to finish off the series in Game 6 on Sunday at the Island Savings Center in Duncan, British Columbia. Reporting for iFiber One Sports, I'm Chris Hansen.